Grown-ups and children have always been curious about the universe, their world, themselves, and all that is around them. A study of all these phenomena is a part of science. Fascinated by science and convinced that science should be an integral part of India's future, the visionary scientist Homi Bhabha conceived of an institution that would further this cause. With encouragement from the scientifically inclined Jawaharlal Nehru and help from J.R.D. Tata, there was born in 1945 the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, more popularly known as TIFR. Let us begin with the universe at large. The nearest star to Earth is our own Sun. The Sun's core is incredibly hot. In fact, it is a thermonuclear furnace manufacturing elements. The elements of everyday life are, in fact, cooked inside the stars. Astrophysicists infer the inner temperature and composition of the Sun by studying its surface oscillations. The evolution of stars depends upon their mass and the environment around them. Massive stars explode to become supernovae. They leave behind very compact objects like neutron stars and black holes with their own unique signatures. Not all stars are lonely. Some have companions. They revolve around each other. Galaxies are cosmic zoom lenses which magnify distant objects, making them brighter. All these are fascinating aspects of our cosmos, which are investigated by scientists at TIFR. In order to construct their history, astronomers study the light emanating from the stars in different wavelength regions. However, many observations can be done only from beyond the Earth's atmosphere. TIFR scientists use enormous plastic balloons, each the size of a 25-story building, to carry huge instruments to heights of 30 to 40 kilometers for these studies. Astronomers study how stars are born in dusty gas clouds by studying their infrared radiation. Scientists have also sent instruments aboard satellites to study X-rays and gamma rays from heavenly bodies. The structure of the universe is being explored with the UTI radio telescope that has been operating for well over 25 years. To probe further and deeper into the universe, the National Center for Radio Astrophysics at Pune has built the world's largest radio telescope at meter wavelengths. Our Earth is bombarded by high energy particles. These are called cosmic rays. Laboratories set up in the hills of Uti, Pachmari, and in the mines of the Kolar goldfields are ideally suited for detecting these cosmic rays as they interact with our atmosphere. An Indo-Japanese collaborative experiment at the Kolar goldfield even tested the stability of protons to find that they live longer than 100,000 billion years. Molecular biology is the study of living organisms at the molecular level. How organisms grow, multiply, form various organs and reproduce, all this can be studied using simple model systems such as yeast, algae and moss cells and fruit flies. By modification of the genes, we can alter the physical structure and behavior of living organisms, whether animal or vegetable. TIFR scientists are also trying to understand diseases and the mechanism of naturally occurring immunity against malaria. Also, the growth of cancerous cells in the mouth due to the harmful effects of tobacco. Studies of large molecules and genetics have become vital to our understanding of life. Scientists at the National Center for Biological Sciences in Bangalore have been studying large organic molecules. Some of the topics being investigated are protein folding, ion transport across biological membranes, the disease cycle of viruses, nerve and muscle development, the senses of smell and taste, and gene regulation in nervous systems. Life is a complex interplay of various chemical reactions. What are the fundamental laws governing these reactions, and how do they occur? Scientists in the Department of Chemical Sciences are engaged in answering such intricate questions. The answers lie in the knowledge of the structures and properties of molecules. The technique of nuclear magnetic resonance is used to probe the atomic structure in liquids. Ultra-fast lasers are used to measure the molecular motions in liquids and gases. Studies of highly complex molecules, such as proteins, nucleic acids, and biomembranes, are being carried out to understand biological processes. Such studies will help in designing drugs and molecular sensors which are of help to humanity. Matter and mankind have been so intimately connected that civilizations are known by the materials that they have used. The stone, bronze and iron ages are all characterized by materials available during that period. We have progressed by inventing new materials according to our requirements. Materials behave very strangely under different conditions. Very small particles of known materials, such as silver, are not easy to recognize. At very low temperatures, materials change their property very dramatically, and superconductivity is one of the important aspects of research at low temperatures. All this requires ultra-cold liquids, such as liquid helium. TIFR scientists have produced multi-layer semiconductor materials, which are used in making tiny lasers that can be used in delicate surgery. The interaction of electrons, atoms, and molecules are investigated using lasers. Lasers are also used for probing chemical reactions, molecular dynamics in liquids, in living biological cells, and in isolated super-cold molecules. TIFR has a medium energy accelerator or atom smasher. It enables scientists to bombard targets with fast-moving heavy elements for research in nuclear, atomic, and material sciences. The focus in nuclear physics is on the behavior of exotic nuclei produced at the accelerator. The energy output of this accelerator is being boosted using indigenously developed superconducting linear accelerator technology. Collisions between particles at extremely high energies help us to understand some of the deepest questions, such as, what is matter made of? And what are elementary particles? TIFR collaborates in this task with CERN in Europe and the Fermi Lab in the USA to use man-made particle accelerators. This enables studies of particles that travel very close to the speed of light. The collisions of high-energy particles enable scientists to understand the constituents of matter. Such experiments led to the discovery of the top quark, an elementary constituent of matter. It was also established that there are only three types of neutrinos in the universe. The next generation of experiments is likely to answer the fundamental question regarding the origin of mass. Scientists at TIFR are also investigating the nature of gravity. Activities at TIFR would not be possible without a strong backing of technology and infrastructure. A great deal of the required equipment is fabricated in-house in the well-equipped workshop and maintained by Central Services. TIFR possesses a very fine library and a flexible administrative structure. TIFR also has a very modern and impressive computer network. Today, computers are very common. They have a wide variety of applications. What are the limits of computers? How reliable is the software? Can one go beyond traditional mathematical models? These are some of the questions that are being asked by the computer scientists at the Institute. Several institutions have emerged from the expertise generated at TIFR. These include separate units at the Department of Electronics, National Center for Software Technology, the Center for Development of Telematics, the National Informatics Center, and the Society for Microwave Electronics and Engineering Research. The first digital computer built in India was designed and fabricated in the Institute in the late 50s. Mobile digital switching systems for defense applications, computer networking, and VLSI were developed at the Institute. Computers are a tool to simulate the complex nature of natural phenomena. Theoretical physicists try to understand and explain natural phenomena. It is amazing to discover the beautiful structures and symmetries in nature. Scientists seek the theory which describes the basic constituents of matter by studying complex phenomena relating to matter. We have all heard of black holes which swallow everything. Where does all this information go? Scientists feel that they are on the verge of solving this mystery. Fundamental mathematics is a common link to all these studies, apart from being a powerful field of study in its own right. It has been said that mathematics is the queen and servant of science. It was Professor K. Chandrasekharan who founded the School of Mathematics at TIFR and attracted and nurtured young mathematicians from all over the country. Mathematics, down the ages, has concerned itself with equations of one kind or the other. For example, when you cut a cone, you get an ellipse. And if you drop a pebble in a pond, it makes a wave. Both these can be expressed in terms of equations. Mathematicians at TIFR now work at the frontiers of the four branches of mathematics: number theory, algebra, geometry, and advanced calculus. It is at the point of interaction between these branches that mathematics is most exciting. Work on applied mathematics is carried out at the Bangalore Center, describing diverse phenomena from machines to meteorology. Mathematicians at TIFR have been studying structures such as algebraic geometry, number theory, group theory, and dynamical systems. Experience gained through dedication and insight by scientists at TIFR is continually passed on to the coming generation through training of young scientists at the Institute. The Institute's graduate school forms the backbone of a lot of research work at TIFR. The Homi Bhabha Center for Science Education in Mumbai has been working towards the improvement of science and mathematics education right from the school level. Thank you. The center tries to improve the learning skills and teaching methods of students and teachers through research and fieldwork. TIFR scientists are also involved in the popularization of science and dissemination of scientific knowledge. Students and teachers, whether they are in the classroom, library, canteen, or walking in the garden, are continuously involved in a dialogue concerning the fundamental mysteries of nature. Every country needs a place like this, a place where gifted and motivated scientists may question, raise doubts, probe, experiment, analyze, and occasionally solve some of the secrets of nature. One such place is the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research.